Today, our subject matter is characteristics of antigen and antibody, immunoglobulin types and their function. Now, I am going to demonstrate what is an antigen. Antigen, in general, is a protein substance, but it may be lipid, polysaccharide or nucleic acid. It can invade our body and cause disease. It can stimulate B lymphocyte to produce antibody. It is of two types, self and non-self. Self antigen or autoantigen originates in our body or within our body, but foreign antigen originates outside our body. The example of foreign antigen includes virus, bacteria, protozoa, the snake venom, etc. If we consider the picture of antigen, then we find this is a bacterial cell and the sites that is antigenic determinant or epitope on antigen is specific for antibody A and this structure is specific for antibody B. As for example, these structures or this binding is very essential for antigen-antibody interaction. As I have said earlier, this structure is called epitope or the antigenic determinant. They bind to the paratope, that is the binding site of the antibody. The characteristics of antigen include their foreign substances capable of entering the body and can cause disease. In general, two main divisions are found, that is foreign antigen, autoantigen. It has a property to induce a detectable immune response. That is, the antigen can stimulate the lymphocyte to produce antibody or to attack the antigen directly is called an immunogen. Epitope is immunologically active region of an antigen that binds to antigen-specific receptors on lymphocyte or secreted antibodies. Most antigens have large molecular weight. There are low molecular weight substances called haptens capable of producing an immune response. Antigen is chemically composed of proteins in general. Now, I will show you the picture of an antibody molecule, or I will discuss that what is an antibody. Antibodies are heavy globular protein belonging to the immunoglobulin superfamily. They are made up of two heavy and two small chain, that is light chain, two heavy chain and two light chain. This picture shows you a clear diagram of an immunoglobulin molecule, that is the green one is heavy chain and the blue one is the light chain, and this is the variable region of an antibody. And this is the constant region. This is the constant region. There are five isotypes of immunoglobulin, that is IgA, IgG, IgE, IgD and IgM. The different antibody isotopes denote different types of heavy chain, that is alpha, gamma, delta, epsilon and mu. Antibodies are used by our immune system to neutralize pathogen such as bacteria, viruses. If we consider the basic characteristics of the classes of immunoglobulin, then we can find that IgA is found in gastrointestinal, respiratory and urogenital tract mucosa. It prevents the colonization by pathogen, also present in saliva, tears and milk. IgD, that is a membrane immunoglobulin, it is part of the membrane receptor of naive B lymphocyte. IgE, that is involved in allergic reaction or parasitic processes, Its interaction with basophil and mastocytes causes histamine release. IgG, the main immunoglobulin of our acquired immunity. You know, there are two types of immunity, humoral immunity and cell-mediated immunity. Antibodies are involved in humoral immunity. So, IgG is the main antibody, the only antibody that is capable of crossing the placenta to give passive immunity to the fetus. And lastly, the IgM, immunoglobulin M. It is the part of membrane receptor of naive B lymphocyte, and it also found in serum secreted early in acquired immune response. If we consider the structure of immunoglobulin in details, then we can find this is the light chains and this is the heavy chains. This is the hinge region and those are the disulfide bond that joins these chains. These are interchain disulfide bond and those are intrachain disulfide bond because they are within one chain. And this is the variable region and this is the constant region. And this is the fragment of antibody, that FAB region, and this is the crystallizable fragment, that is FC region of an antibody. If we come to the antigen-antibody reaction, then we can find the antibody's paratope, that is the binding site of an antibody, interact with antigen's epitope. They interact by spatial complementarity. That is, if you notice the picture, you can see the activated immune cells makes more antibodies. The sky blue antibodies are there and the red dot represents the antigen. So here the antigen antibody binding occurs and macrophage engulfs the antigen antibody complex and finally destroys it. So this is the process called phagocytosis. In this process, antibody destroys an antigen. Antigen-antibody interact by spatial complementarity, that is lock and key model. The molecular forces involved in this process include hydrogen bond, ionic bond, hydrophobic interaction and van der Waal interaction. This is the hydrogen bond and ionic bond, hydrophobic interaction, van der Waal interaction, that is van der Waal forces. The forces are weak and non-specific. If we consider the major functions of different isotypes of immunoglobulin, then we can notice that IgG is the main antibody. In the secondary response, it opsonizes bacteria, making them easier to phagocytize. It fixes complement, which enhances bacterial cleaning, neutralizes bacterial toxins and viruses, and crosses the placenta. The IgA antibody, that is a secretory antibody, prevents attachment of bacteria and viruses to mucosal membrane, that is mucous membrane. And IgM, which is produced in primary response, fixes complement. Antigen receptor on the surface of B cell. IgD, the function of IgD is uncertain, It is found on the surface of many B cells as well as in serum. IgE mediates immediate hypersensitivity by causing release of mediators from mast cells and basophils upon exposure to antigen, that is allergen, because IgE is involved in allergenic reaction or allergic reaction rather. It defend against worm infection also. Its main host defense is against helminth infection. So students, I think this will benefit you in your preparation. Thank you.